Hello, 12th class. So this is your lecture 4. In this, I'll explain the summary of the chapter. So first, what is network? As I told you before, that when two or more computers connected in a way so that they can share the resources they form a network. It is called the network. So computer network is a network of computer which share information resources from each other. Okay, this network can be connected by cable, telephone line and radio wave, satellite, infrared, etc. Now, advantages of networking. So these are the advantages that I already discussed. So these are resource sharing, effective communication, less expenses, reliability, center storage of data. Next is disadvantages of data. So you know the disadvantages. These are the disadvantages that we have already discussed. Okay, so this is the summary class, so you have to just read it. Next is evolution of network. So in 1969, first network came into existence, then the ARPANET, then mid-80s NSF net was come. Now major components of computer network, that is host or nodes, server, client, network hardware, communication channel, software and network devices. Network services. So we just talk about these in brief. Major components of computer network, that is a host that attached to a computer and that means to share some resources of the network. Server that contain all the information. It is like a database that store the data. Then client is a host computer that request for some services from the server. Network hardware. So there are many type of hardware that are required in a network, that is NIC, network interface card, then hub switch and router, and many more are there. Now communication channel can be wired or wireless. So wired means that are connected with the wire, for example coaxial cable, fiber optic cable, twisted pair cable. Wireless means no need to connect with the help of the wire, for example your satellite, your radio waves, infrared, etc. Next is software. So the software layer of a network that makes the networking possible. Okay, it comprises of the network protocols and the network operating system. Now next is network services. So that this refers to the application that provide different functionalities over a network. For example, your DNS, domain name system, your file sharing, your voice over internet protocol and many more. Next is types of network. So a computer network means a group of networked computer, that is a computer that are linked by means of a communication system. So they depends on it may be different in size, complexity and geographical spread. So there are then let us discuss the types of network based on three parameter, that is size, complexity and geographical spread. So based on geographical spread, network are of two type, that is LAN and WAN. So now first is LAN, that is local area network. It is a small type of network in which we can access only the residence, school, laboratory, university campus and the office building. Okay, this device can be worked in a room also, in a building or in a campus, and the approximate area is 1 to 10 kilometer, and it is used by using the wired or wireless media. Both ways we can use the LAN. Next is WAN, that is wide area network. If you talk about the countries, if you want to share data across the countries, then you have to use the WAN, wide area network. It covers over hundreds of kilometer radius. Its networks are ATMs, banks, national and international organization offices. Okay, so it is usually formed by interconnecting LANs, WANs or maybe other WANs. The example is internet. Now next is MAN. So metropolitan area network, it covers a city. So the distance is the area of few kilometer to few hundred kilometer radius. Its example are network of schools, banks, government offices within a city are the example of MAN. Now next is PAN. So PAN means when you want to connect the devices with a very small area. For example, Bluetooth. Okay, by Bluetooth, or you want to transfer the data by USB also. So this is your PAN, that is personal area network. Now this is the diagram. This is the types of computer network. Here the first one is the wide area network. So when you want to talk about the country or any continent, then you have to use a world area network, wide area network. Then if you want to cover the city, then you have to use metropolitan area network. And if you want to connect with two building or a school or a campus, then you have to use a local area network. And the personal area network is very when you have a very short distance. Now internet. So internet basically is that in which whatever information we want to search, we just get the result within time. So this is your internet. These are some points. Now next is internet. Internet is a private network or computer that which works on the internet protocol. So any organization can use the internet for its security purpose. Okay, because internet is a private network, so here security is more. So this is the diagram of types of network based on communication channel, that is wired or unwired. So these are the types. In wired you have twisted pair cable, coaxial cable and optical fiber, and in wireless you have the infrared waves, radio waves, microwave, satellite and Bluetooth and Wi-Fi. Next is twisted pair cable. So twisted pair cable, this is a type of these are the pictures of twisted pair cable. Okay, so this is the category 5 and category 6 that are generally used in LAN. Okay, now next is advantage. It is cheap, lightweight, flexible, easy to install and maintain. And disadvantages are it is effective up to 100 meters only. After this we need the repeaters. It supports a low bandwidth with the speed up to 100 Mbps. Now next is coaxial cable, that is coax. So this is the diagram of coaxial cable and these are the points. We already discussed these points. Generally we use this with used in our TV system that is connected with the cable. Next is advantages. So these are the advantages. It has a high bandwidth, so it is suitable for the cable TV connection. It has the less it is less sensitive towards the electromagnetic field. And disadvantages, as compared to twisted pair cable, it is less flexible and is expensive. Its installation is not easy due to thickness of 1 cm diameter and it has poor flexibility. Optical fiber cable, this is the best cable. Why it is best? Because in this data are transferred in the form of light rays. Okay, and signals are to be emitted by the LED or the laser beam from the source. This is a diagram of optical fiber cable. Now these are the advantages and disadvantages of optical fiber cable. Now these are the factor or the comparison between twisted pair coaxial cable and the optical fiber cable that we already discussed. Now wireless media. In wireless media there are some term that is radio wave. So radio wave has the frequency 3 GHz to 3 GHz. Now the signals are modified on high speed audio radio wave. Okay, so in this diagram you can see the radio waves are at the ground wave and radio waves are on the ionosphere. Okay, so here you can see the signals in radio waves, the data can easily be transmitted. These are the advantages and disadvantages of radio waves. Microwave. In this you have to install the two direct parabolic antennas so that they can send and receive the signals. This is the example. Now these are the advantages and disadvantages of microwaves. Next is infrared waves. So you already know what is infrared waves. You can use infrared waves in cameras, in phone, in remote, in car keys, etc. So that is a technique used in computer is similar to the technique that used in remote operated electronic equipment like TV, your cordless phone, toys, etc. Next is advantage, and this is the disadvantage. Now satellite link. So satellite communication uses a microwave as a medium. So satellites like geostationary or polar satellites are used to set the transmission on various center on earth. So the services of satellites are DTH, VSAT, GPS, satellite phone that have become possible by satellite transmission. And satellite also works as a transceiver antenna in space, which receive and regenerate and redirect the signal. So satellite is very important. Next is, this is the advantage and disadvantage of satellite. Now some network devices, or we can say the hardware devices that are used in network, that is hub, switch, gateway, repeater and router. So hub is a device in which we can connect the several computers. So this is the image of hub. Next is switch. So switch, that is a it is also a type of hub, but it contains a filter which filters the data before sending, and it is then directed to the intended node only. Next is repeater. Repeater is used when the length of signal is get weak. Okay, and you want to increase the length of signal, then you have to use the repeater. Now next is gateway. So gateway, when you have the two different network that use different hardware and software, then you have to use the gateway. Now next is router. So router is used when you want to send the data from the source machine to destination machine. It always take the shortest path. Which path is shorter, it just send the message to that path. So next is your cloud computing. Yes, now cloud computing, that is a internet based computing. So whatever the data you want to store on cloud, you can easily store, and at whenever you want to access data, you can easily access. But the condition is you have a data internet connection for accessing the data. Now these are the advantages and disadvantages of cloud computing. You have to just read this. Cloud computing, it is a four type, that is private cloud, public clouds, community cloud and hybrid clouds. So private cloud means that is just exclusively used by a single organization, okay, and also controlled by the single organization, and it is managed and hosted by the private data centers. Now next is your public clouds. So these are used by the multiple organization on a shared basis, that is your public clouds. Next is your community cloud. So these are the clouds for use by a group of related organization who wish to make use of a common cloud computing environment. Now hybrid cloud, when a single organization adopts both the private and the public cloud, that is your hybrid clouds. Next is Internet of Things. So Internet of Things, whenever you use the internet, okay, so that is known as your Internet of Things. So we can say that all the things that are connected to internet are called the Internet of Things. Its components are sensors, connectivity, people and processes. So these are the technologies, that is RFID, radio frequency identification. Now sensors, smart technology, software and the efficient network connectivity. This is a RFID, radio frequency identification. In this technology is designed to use the radio waves to read and capture information stored on a tag, that called a RFID. And this RFID is connected with a small chip that is attached to an antenna. Sensor that is able to detect the changes in the environment. This is just an example. So sensor that collect the data about the status of the thing. Now smart technologies. The smart technology include the additional functionality to take action and the other processing capabilities as per the requirement. For example, your refrigerator, for example, again that is locking or unlocking a door, adjusting the temperature of an oven, okay, switching off the lights. These all are the example of smart technologies. Now software. Software is also very important of to use these technology. So the software that provides the reusable solutions for connecting and taking actions and solving issues that may arise. Next is efficient network connectivity. So you have a good network connection to access all these things. Now these are the devices that can form IoT. Okay, so these are some devices that you already know. Now the homework of lecture 3. I gave you homework. These three are the questions that you have to write it in your notebook. I hope these questions are clear now. Okay, you can easily write the answers by just go through with this PPT. So your homework is you have to just revise the complete chapter of chapter 11. Your chapter is completed. In the next video, I'll give you the assignment. So thank you and have a nice day.